First of all, we have an integrated system. We're planning to implement in many stages so that we keep everyone safe. So let me briefly explain those line of defenses, if you like.
Okay.
The first is that before you come in Ukraine, before you come to Greece, you need to either be vaccinated and have a certificate issued by the Ukrainian authorities, mm-hmm. or to have a negative test before you come. The second requirement is that when you come, you will be subject to testing. So we will have our teams, not everyone will be tested, of course, but a percentage of people, depending on the positivity rates, we have a very sophisticated artificial intelligence system that decides who's going to be tested and who's not, depending whether they come, whether they're vaccinated, and all those things. The third is whether the third line of defense is the quarantine hotels. We had last year quarantine hotels. We will have them this year. So if you are found positive, together with the family, you will be isolated for a number of 10 days to a quarantine hotel. The fourth line of defense is that we are implementing very strict protocols in order to ensure that everyone is safe. We implemented them last year. We're updating them this year to make a few changes, but effectively the very successful protocols of last year that kept mm-hmm. everyone with no problems safe will be implemented in the buses, in the hotels, in the travel agents. Every person in the tourist ministry will be subject to those protocols. And of course, they have to be followed by our friends from Ukraine that will decide to come to Greece. We are building a wall of trust, a wall of immunity by vaccinating on priority the personnel of the tourism sector. So everyone working in tourism, the drivers, the guides, the people serving in the hotels, etc., will be vaccinated as a priority. Of course, as soon as we finish with the vulnerable, the vaccination of the older people and people that have illnesses, because of course, well, on the legal basis, we have looked this, you know, checked this through. We are allowed to allow traveling. And of course, we will start with the European Union. As I explained, we will gradually lift the restrictions on the way to the 14th of May. On the 14th of May, we have the full system in place. So we will lift restrictions with specific third countries. This is not with every third country. Well, of course, we will have Russia, we will have Belarus, we will have other countries from the Middle East. We basically have the countries that are important for us touristically. And of course, Ukraine is a country where people like to come to Greece. Well, we are already in technical discussions to understand the details on what kind of vaccination papers you issue, whether they're digital, who issues them, etc. So we gather all the information that is required in order to be able to accept those and be able to check them at our borders. So we will agree those details. Now, whether we will do it with exchanging of the foreign ministry is exchanging letters correspondingly, or we will sign an agreement. That's a format that it will depend. But the reality is the same. We will be able to accept Ukrainian people coming to our borders, and of course, hopefully, Greeks that want to come to Ukraine. We have mixed marriages. We have people that have ties between the two countries, and we want to allow those people to be able to travel. I want to say that we always put an asterisk. We always put an asterisk that, of course, the health situation allows it. We always monitor, we talk with our doctors, and they all check again, and they give us the green light, and we move on and move on. So I cannot, for this year, be 100% certain. Everything is under the fine print that we have to check the health situation as well. We will try to take every measure not to create a problem for the market, of course, but at the same time, it's a dynamic situation. So we will do whatever is necessary to keep both Ukrainians and Greeks safe. We want to keep everyone out of harm's way. So this is our number one priority. Because we always put safety first, we were able to be much better than other countries in this crisis. So this is how we're operating. We'll continue doing so. We will do it, however, with a minimum disruption to everyone. That's why we decided to choose a date where things will have progressed and there's a small risk of changes. So 14th of May is a date where we can project with confidence that things will go according to plan. We're hoping as well that during the summer, we will be able also to accept antigen tests instead of PCR tests, bringing the cost of travel further down. Now, I cannot yet say, you know, when exactly this will happen. It could be even from the 14th of May. And also, depending on the positive rates that we find in our borders, we could make changes to that. But the basic plan is to try to ensure, without the risk, as many countries as possible to allow the antigen test. There is no extra documents. You don't even have to bring your smile, because we guarantee that we will give you a smile back when you go, when you leave Greece. So there are no extra documents. Of course, your passport and your anything else that you need in any other year, plus the antigen, or the PCR test, or the vaccination certificate. Yes, well, any certificate that is valid for Ukrainian authorities. That's why we're waiting for the Ukrainian authorities to give us, you know, examples of those certificates, so that we can check them at our borders. Will be valid. And of course, we're aiming to accept third-party vaccines as well. So we're compiling the list of vaccines that are being used in the third countries that we're interested, like Ukraine. And we're hoping that our doctors will sort of give us the list that they consider acceptable. Hopefully, I mean, we're certain that this list will include all the vaccines, that which has to have the important details in English. So it has to be in English as well. This is why we're discussing with the relevant authorities, because as you can imagine, we cannot check it in every language of every country that people come. The discussions are ongoing. Of course, we're exchanging information, and I'm pretty confident that people will respond in the correct time. It has to be from an accredited lab. So it has to be from a lab. You cannot just show the kids. Yes. It has to be from a lab that's valid. I'm not sure yet, to be fair, but I think this is either WHO or an ECDC list. There are international lists of labs that are accredited with the right procedures to perform those tests. Well, I mean, we discussed this, at length with our doctors, and apparently the discussion about the kids has changed than last year, because it seems that the kids spread the disease a lot. Yeah. So the minimal age that they have decided on is 5 years old. So any kid over 5 years old has to be subjected to a negative test. There's no other limit than any normal year. So You can stay as long as you could stay in 2019, for example. So there's no extra limits, no nothing of that sort. And also there's no need to take other tests. Only if you have symptoms. Yeah, well, what we do is ensure that you have access to our national health system as if you were a Greek citizen. So as far as COVID is concerned, if you have symptoms and you need to be tested, you're tested, and it's free of charge. And then if you need to go to hospital, you go to hospital and it's free of charge. And then if you need to, heaven forbid, go to an ICU unit and anything you might need, it's all free of charge. So our health system is at your service, just like it is with Greeks. It doesn't cover any extra stays or anything else that you might need. But our isolation hotels will be, if there are places, will be used to host people that need to stay, perhaps. Mm-hmm. So in some cases, we might use those. But we cannot guarantee that, because, of course, those hotels have a specific capacity. So I think this is the best way to just to have the peace of mind that anything that might happen, you're covered. We're doing this is, of course, because we miss our friends from Ukraine. We want to see your friendly faces again. We want to ensure that in Greece, we expect you with open arms, but we also do it in a way that both fulfills your wants to you. That's why our motto for this year is, if I say this in Ukrainian, you will fix it if it's wrong. So vi hotsete tse Grecia, so all you want is Greece. So this is important for us to keep everyone relaxed, but also safe. So that's it. Yeah. So we're at your service to answer any questions or issues that might arise.